a recap of all the stuff we've learned so far in these 4 weeks. Like, this was the original thing I put on the thing. Alden said, we're gonna do a workshop, and we're just gonna create a web app. Some of you are like, I don't know what that means, but you showed up anyways. See, it doesn't sound so bad. You just go, oh, web app. Okay, I know HTML, I know CSS, how bad can this be? How bad it can be.
Yeah.
So this is some of the topics, most of the topics that we've covered so far. Wait, how do you get Zoom 200? So this was just to give you I like visual stuff, so this helps to think about like the kind of grouping of ideas we covered, like idea of prototypes. You can do those in sketches, wireframes, paper prototypes. There's user testing. And then there's version control with Git, which works locally. And then, hopefully people know the difference between Git and GitHub. Everybody got that? Kind of? Oh, good. Because that's like one of the hardest things you have to get over. It's like, no, that's not GitHub, that's Git. Okay. Understand the difference. And then there's all the stuff about languages. For each language, there's the idea that, okay, if I need to get libraries from somewhere, there's going to be somewhere that stores these libraries, and each language has a different one. And then there's a tool, somehow, that I can use to install these libraries, and that's the package manager. And then the web framework. I was like, oh geez, that's a lot of stuff. But it's true. So didn't cover, the HTTP verbs. That was the thing that I just covered with the form, how most of it was Git commands where you just read stuff. But then when you actually need to change stuff, it's a post. There's actually three other ones. Put and patch, which does the updating, and then when you delete stuff, the HTTP verbs actually delete, but forms, they don't do that. Forms only do two things. So that's why I had to, even though I was deleting stuff, I had to send it as a post request, because forms can't handle delete. But if you do, you can do it in JavaScript, like if you talk to an API, those you can actually have the command to go delete, and put and post. And then there's the other part of the web framework is there's lots of different types. Most of you are just doing the server rendered because that's one example, but then you could do SPA. I think one group, your group, is just doing SPA, right?
I'm not sure.
Not sure anymore? Okay, there's one group that's just doing that, in theory, is only doing a single page app with React. And I know there's one group that's doing single page app with APIs, and they're in a lot of pain right now. But the idea of that, there's different ways you can make a web app. And simplest is probably like this, and then it gets a little bit more complicated. And so for beginners, just do that a couple of times, and then move on down. Probably won't have to, you can try doing a single page app and APIs later, but not as the first thing. And we also talked about CSS frameworks. It's like, I'm happy that people are using CSS frameworks, because sometimes when you do, okay, I went to a boot camp and some of the projects, it looked like an engineer designed it, because you know what that, yeah, you went to boot camp too, so you know what that means. So I'm just glad that, for most part, at least your apps don't look like an engineer did it. Just add a little bit of style. You can get fancier if you want. You find out you actually like that more, do that more, then learn today about CSS processors too. And then hiding secrets, get ignored. No, please don't put your passwords up in Git. That's all I ask. Because there are actually robots who scrape GitHub looking for people's passwords. They go, oh, I got a password to Amazon account. Guess what? That's where I'm going to store my stuff now. And then .env, the other thing we covered was, oh, how do you, I need to keep secrets in my app. Where do I keep them? Keep in the .env file, then Git ignore that file. Then the idea of data sources and databases. You know, databases cover the thing of data modeling. It's like, okay, how do I turn my app, things that are in my app, into actual physical things that are saved somewhere? It's the idea of, you know, creating tables or collections. And then there are different types. Cover mostly relational, and then there's this thing called SQL, which is how you talk to the database. And when you do, there, you know, you have the CRUD commands. And then there's the NoSQL, which I briefly mentioned, but actually didn't talk that much about. But it exists, in case you ever hear that word. They go, NoSQL, you're like, okay, I don't know what it does, but it's a kind of database-y thing. And then the other source was APIs, which is just basically they're just sending data, no HTML, just data. I don't think we didn't cover GraphQL, I'm sorry. It exists. But basically, the one theory was REST was, okay, I need to see my list of teams, so I'm going to grab everything from the teams, the entire table. And then people go, I actually don't need all that information. I just want the name. Why am I grabbing everything for that table? So people are thinking, okay, how else can we do it? And one of the other ideas that was called GraphQL, it's another way to set up an API. And then this one, they go, oh, I only want the name from the team. I only need the name from the users. And that's all you get back. So you get less information back. You only get the information you want. And then we also covered a little bit about authentication. There's different ways you can authenticate. You can do username, password. You can do OAuth is when you connect to other services. When you ever see login with GitHub, login with Facebook, that kind of thing. That's kind of OAuth. And JWT, that's if you need to auth with like your server, your single page app needs to log in. And then authorization, that's when you decide in your app, it could be, okay, people who aren't logged in, they can only see the home page. People who are logged in, you can see everything else. So that's one simple version of authorization. And then it can also be role-based, which you go, okay, if you're an admin, you can see this stuff. If you're a regular user, you can see this stuff. If you're this level, you can see that stuff. And then we talked a little bit about deployment, about the different companies you can host with Heroku, AWS. She did something else. You did DigitalOcean. If you want to set up your own server, like you got 2 weeks, go ping her, because I haven't done that yet. But if you want to, you might find out you actually like doing that kind of stuff. And then just the idea of once you get into a job, you might come up with continuous integration and deployment because you're trying to push stuff live all the time. Hopefully you pass all your tests while pushing. And then the idea of domain registration of, you know, hey, I want a thing that's called, you know, metro.org. How do I get that hooked up to my app? So these are some of the hopefully stuff that we covered. So my hope is at least you understand the first level words. As you do this for the second time, let's try to understand a little bit deeper, or try different branches of this. But that was, because I think John mentioned it's word soup, and yeah, when you're like doing this for like first 2 weeks ever, you're like, there's too many words. But then as you learn more and you get to more, you go, oh, that word goes to this part, that word goes to that part, that word goes to that part. So it begins to make a little bit more sense. So that's it for that lecture. And I'll upload this somewhere in case anyone wants to see this or edit it. Tell me it was wrong.